Hello children, how are you all? This is Sridevi from Tala Padmavati International School, Warangal. Welcome back to the second part of the topic from history, that is outbreak of revolution. In the previous topic, we heard about the king, the three types of people, so on. We heard about the king, where he is not able to take proper decision about the people, and even we heard about the people who are suffering a lot with many problems like high demand of products where they were unable to purchase, paying of tax, etc. And even we have seen that society was completely based on inequality. Apart from this, even we heard that the king himself was unable to decide to increase the tax. He must take the permission from Estate General, a political body of France. And even we talked about this Estate General, which is a body of all the state representatives or the participants of the members, or we can say the members who belongs to the political body. And here the thing we have to notice is the estate is of three parts of members. Like, we can say the estate members are being divided into three particular parts, where who are being called as the representatives in the groups. Like to say the three parts were being called as the estates: the first estate, second estate, or else the third estate. In the first estate, we see the 300 members. In the second estate, 300 members. And even in the third estate also, 300 members. This implementation of tax, where the king was about to inform the Estate General, was around on 5th May in the year 1780. So when it comes to the topic, the three estate bodies where we are going to see in this, each members of the estates are given the single power, like I mean to say is the vote power. And here we have to notice, in each estate that is, will have the power of one vote to the whole group members. Like all the 300 members can give together only one vote. Like, you can see the in the image, first estate 300 members one vote, second estate 300 members one vote, and even the third estate 600 members with one vote. Means overall together, one estate is having the power to give only one vote. But here, if you can see the third estate of 600 members, instead of getting two votes, the third estate don't have any right of getting two votes. Actually, being 600 members, 300 one vote money, the 600 members must get the two votes. But in the third estate, we did not notice any such thing of difference, where they are also given only the power of single vote. And if here the first estate and the second estate join the hands and claim, and if they pass the motion, like if they unite together in the government, unite together in the general estate, where they finalize their unity, the tax will be finalizing and it will be increased according to the first estate and the second estate. And here we have to see the thing is, should they pay or don't pay any amount, the tax and the entire tax which was being finalized will be the complete burden which will fall on the third estate. So the third estate people demanded that there must be change in the process, that instead of one state one vote, there must be one person with only one vote. This would be really a logical and understanding based on the situation. So it would be like the one estate 300 members with 300 votes. It was really acceptable. And the second estate 300 members with 300 votes. In the same way, the third estate also will be treated with 600 members with 600 votes. Basically, it must be done that way. That will be the right way, or that will be the correct decision to be taken. And this would be on the principle of democratic equality. Even this proposal was being forwarded in front of the king, but the king denied this proposal, where he was not ready to accept this proposal, or he rejected this proposal. Instead, he said that whatever is going on from that past, means since the years how the action of decisions were being taken by the Ghana General Estate, the same even in the future, the decision of the king was in such a way, and will be on no change even in the future also. But such situation and final decision of the king was not acceptable by the Third Estate people, or the whole group were very angered. Obviously, it is an injustice for the Third Estate people, where they were being demanded to give one single vote. So they were very much serious, and the meeting on 20th June, the Third Estate members assembled at an indoor tennis court and formed or declared themselves as National Assembly. So finally, the Third Estate people formed a National Assembly and declared a motto in the form of the constitution, which will limit the power of king, because king is not the person to decide anything. As you can see in the image, they gathered in a Bastille fort, where and the same, he can't take the decision and he can't be the final person in approving the decision. And some people were busy in preparing the constitution, and most of the people marched towards the Bastille fort. Actually, they were in an anger for increasing the tax, and they were very angry with the king, and even they approached to that fort and they bursted up this fort into pieces and destroyed it completely. That was happened in the year 14th of July 1789, and that pieces were sold in the market as a symbol of freedom. And that was really a historical event to say, where they were fighting for the equality and the status of equal living conditions for all the people. So it was an historical event in the whole France, and the people in France, and they declared that moment changed their life. Where they were decided to fight with the king, or else decided to break up the rules which were being fought by them. That was around in the year 14 July 1789, where this situation was being taken place. And that day of 14th July, that is 1789, was celebrated as the National Day of France. So at that situations, as people were feeling very free of themselves, where they declared their freedom of life. After this, the king realized that even people are very serious regarding the National Assembly and their rights for their constitution. And finally, the king accepted the given proposal by the people, and the king approved the National Assembly. So finally, whatever the people were fighting for, whatever the people were asking for, the demand of equality was being accepted by the king. Now, after the implementation of constitution, special privilege of clergy and nobles was abolished. As we heard in the previous topic also, that there is no such rule for clergy or else the nobles to pay the tax, and they were being given all privileges. So after this declaration of equal status and declaration of self living conditions, after they got their equal status of living conditions, where they were being declared as the free living people, special privileges of clergy and nobles were abolished. Means they are also being demanded to pay the tax for the government. Both new clergy and nobles will also pay the tax. And land under church is now under government, where the land which was being undertaken by the people or the privileged people was completely handed over to the government. Because of these changes, government manages 2 billion levers and paid back their loans. So it was really comfortable, which was given for the people. Living conditions or normal conditions has been brought out, and their loans or whatever are being paid or bear by the government. And third estate people loans, etc. And now, as you all know that we have our own constitution in our country, based on democracy, equality, fraternity and liberty. Even in the same way, the France also got the same type of or method of constitution, in which they got the declaration of the rights of men and the citizens. All the people have the basic rights, freedom of speech, right to live, freedom of opinion, equality before law, etc. These all were the parts of constitutional rights given to each and every citizen of the France. And the other important right is the right to vote. But here the voting system or the right to vote was not based on equality, because they have discriminated the citizens in the passive voters and active voters. So when we talk about, means to say exactly, as the Declaration of Freedom was given, but still there were some sort of negative ruling systems which were being making the people into two types of categories, like active voters or else the passive voters. They were discriminating, means dividing the people according to their living conditions and according to their caste or whatever it is. So the active voters are those who are like 25 years of age, who are paying tax, and all are men. Here we need to notice is the active voters were completely the men, and who are at the age of 25 years and who are paying the regular tax, and they are being given the good importance, and their strength was around 4 million out of 28 million of people all over the France. So 4 million were the total active voters in France. And in the same way, when we talk about passive voters, those are the voters who don't have the voting rights, means these people don't have any right to vote. And those were the people who consider in this group were like women, children and the poor people, and all the people and youth below 25 years. These all were known as the passive voters, and they don't pay tax to the government. So these all were the passive voters. And these voters are basically vote for the two bodies, that is, the first body is judiciary, where you can observe in the image, voting for the judge, and next to they are voting for the electors who are 50,000 members. And later these electors are voters voting for National Assembly members, and they are around 745 members. And these National Assembly members will control the executives, that is, we can call them as where the executives will be controlling the ministers as well as the king. They will be the supreme power or the real power under the constitutional or the National Assembly. So here basically we see the National Assembly members control the king as well as the minister. Now let us know about the symbols in France which are related to elections. So generally, as you all know about the idea of elections, generally in India also, mostly a political party will be symbolizing with a particular symbol, like a fan, or else like we can say cap, like a ring of a finger ring, or anything such like even bucket, or else a pigeon. It's a common thing mostly where they'll be giving such symbols for a particular party. So in the same way, even here also we have such symbols where we see the political bodies. Most and very important thing we notice here is that the symbols are being facilitated so that the uneducated people also can understand that this symbol belongs to one particular party. So So just to make the people to make a common thing of idea to know about the particular party, the symbols were been even introduced in France once upon a time, where they found the uneducated people in that areas. As I told you, it was the symbol, you can see broken chain, which stands for freedom, where it has it gives the clear information that chains were mostly used for fetter slaves. So a broken chain stands for act of becoming free. It's a general opinion where we can understand it. And a bundle of rods, you can see the bundle of rods, which is showing the unity. Commonly, if I give a single stick to you, you break into pieces. It's not a big thing of breaking a small stick or a twig. But whereas if I give a bundle of sticks to you and ask you to break it, it is not that easy to break it. Where that shows the unity or the strongness of unity, the strength which symbolizes the unity. So here the bundle of rod also shows a symbol of unity of that particular country. And it gives the unity of the people, where they need to fight together for freedom, or else for their unity, for their rights and all, for their voting powers, whatever it may be. This gives the clear information about unity. Another thing is, you can see in the image, eye within a triangle radiating light. You can see a triangle within the circular path, circular body, which is showing that the all seeing eye stands for knowledge. The rays of the sun will drive away the clouds of ignorance. It is like the sun around the sun in between the eye, which is symbolizing the knowledge of, it is the rays of knowledge and clouds of ignorance. Drive away the clouds of ignorance means people are learning more and more new to fight for their freedom and for their importance, for their living conditions, for their equal status. So this is what, how slowly they are learning to break out the ignorance and come out with a new light of knowledge, which gives their, which changes their lifestyle. Another one is sceptre, which is a symbol of royalty. It is a symbol of royal power, where it gives the power of royalty, where the living conditions of the people also must be the same or the equal, which supports the living style. The royalty which shows the equal status, where that there will not be any discrimination or differences between the people, and that symbolizes the royalty of the people in that particular country or whatever it may be. And you can see another image, snake biting its tail to form a ring. So even this symbol also shows eternity. A ring has neither beginning nor end. So eternity means it is a power of unity, indirectly to say, or a power of enlightenment, where we need to have that strongness or willpower to fight against and to be united together, which never breaks or which never gets end to its situation. So this snake biting tail is also shows some sort of symbol of eternity. And another one is about a red ferryghain cap, a cap worn by a slave upon becoming free. So this gives a very deep information, that where the common people of the third estate who were being suffering a lot, struggling a lot for their freedom, for their living conditions, even for their per day food also in the previous lesson. So this shows their getting back of freedom, to set themselves free in all the ways, where they are given the freedom of life, freedom of speech, freedom of living conditions, or whatever it may be. This cap symbolizes the freedom of even a slave to live freely with all sort of freedom in his or in his life. This symbolizes in such a way. And now you can see blue, white and red. This is the national color of France. You can see the women with the three colors, that is blue, white and red. This symbolizes the flag of France, which shows the unity and equality, liberty and fraternity, where the intention of this revolution was to give the equal status of equality, liberty and fraternity. So this blue, white and red symbol shows the national color of country France, which gives most importance or the uniqueness of the country. And the winged women, here you can see the winged women, which is showing the personification of the laws. It is the method or the style of the France people, where they symbolizes the laws which were being implemented with the, or which were being shown out with the angels. You can see the appearance of women shown like an angel, the personification of laws, which shows the new method of laws which were being brought out by the people to fight against the rules of a king or the estates, which gives out the law framing for the free living conditions of the people. So this is what the winged women shows out. And the last is the law tablet. The law tablet is same for all, and all are equal before law. So here, as how we are having the Indian constitution, how it is been declared as Indian, according to the court of law, according to the Indian constitution, everyone are equal. There is no discrimination, no caste, no creed or religion or anything. Everything is equally divided in all the people. So here also the tablet also shows the same thing, that same for all, and law is same for all, and everyone are equal before it. So this is all what we have learned from this lesson. I hope you all understood. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay home.